For more updates, click on subscribe and click on bell button for latest notifications. Hi friends, welcome to Tech ARK IT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to see that file test operators are unary operators. File test operators are, I can say that unary operators. So
like, share, comment, and subscribe.
This is the we have a number of operators, like the options, while if you want to do a file testing, most of the times these operators are used to verify the file existence, or the whether the device is block device or regular file, or it has some set permissions, writable permissions, or executable permissions, or whether it has a read-only permissions, or whether it's a directory, or whether it is a file. So all this can be verified using this file test operators. Let's see this, what are those? Okay, file test operators. Let's example say that -b is an operator which can verify that if it is a block special device or not. Block special device in the sense, like example say that /dev/sda1 is the device which is a block device. So like that, if the device is properly block device or not, it can be verified using the -b. -c can be verified using this, whether it is a character special file or not. Example say that /dev/tty is the one which is this character special file. So you can identify whether it is exactly the file or not using this -c. -d can be used to verify that whether it is a directory or file. Okay, -e can use to whether the file, like example say that I provided the file, exact the file path, using that file path, so I can say that okay, that file exists or not. Okay, sometimes we can also provide like a fake path, then verify that whether file exists or not, and whether the file is an regular file or any special file. Using -f you can verify. -g can be used to group ID. So what is that group ID? In the sense, like example say that if you have a file, the file has a set group ID, like SGU ID, then it can verify that SGU ID as there are not bit is set to that file or not. Okay, -h is the option, can be verified using the symbolic link. Like sometimes we create a symbolic links from one file to another file, so that can be verified using the -h option. And -G can be verified, like using the option can be used here, is that file is owned by the effective group ID. Example say that you have user owner and the group, right? So then it can verify that okay, the group ID is effectively matching or not, owned by the effective group ID. Okay, again one more operator is there called K. The K operator verifies that the file has sticky bit set or not. Okay, the sticky bit operator, if it is has a sticky bit, then it can verify that okay, this file has sticky bit. And next one is the L option, can verify that same like the -h, symbolic links can be verified. Symbolic links verifies. and -o owned by the effective user ID or not. Okay, owned by effective user ID, so that can be verified. -p key P is used to verify that the file type is named file or not. The next one is operator R. R can be used whether the file permission it has a read permissions or not. Example, say that file is readable. Okay, if the file do not have any read permissions, then this can be verified using the -r that okay, the file is do not have any read permissions. -s is the like verify the file is whether size greater than zero, which means that sometimes we create empty files. So that time you can use this operator, like this file test operator, to verify that okay, the file has zero size, then you can delete that file. So do not have anything on content on that file, then you can delete that. Okay, -S can be used to verify that socket file is a socket type or not. Okay, -u can be used to set user ID. So user ID is set to that file or not, you can use -u. -w can be used that the file has a writable permissions or not. And final one is that file has an executable permissions or not. So these are the file test operators or unary operators, we call it as. Check the file characteristics. So this can use to check the file characteristics and directory, like whether it is a file or directory kind of stuff. You can use to verify the file's characteristics. Example, we can see few out of this. Okay, example, say that over here I would like to write some example. Say this is exactly in a directory, right? So I'm going to write this example, say if it is directory or not, it should verify using this file operator. So what I'm doing here, it is that I'm just going to write is that it's a directory dot sh, something like that. So now I'm going to write the shell script, and which can use to verify directory or not. Okay, now what I'm using here is that you can use test or if condition. So here -d is for verifying whether it is a directory or not. Okay, so now I'm providing that path. Okay, so I'm saying that echo, if it is true, then it's a directory. It should print this statement, else it should print this statement is that it's not a directory. Okay, so we'll do this way, otherwise we'll maybe use $1 is the positional parameter we will use over here, because this can be used easily, like whenever it is, if you want to change the input simultaneously, this can be helpful over here. Okay, now let's see this. Now I'm going to write this execute this script, it's a directory.sh, and I'm going to provide the path as a positional parameter, first positional parameters. Okay, sorry, I just maybe missed this F5, the closing of the if condition. So now let's run this. So it's a directory. Now in similar way, I'm just going to provide something like there is a file called file test, something like this. So it's saying that it's not a directory. Like this, you can use this method to verify whether the file or it's a directory. Okay, now I'm going to use another operator, it's called like file exist or not, file exist.sh. So I'm going to write this. Okay, let's maybe copy this same it's a directory to file exist.sh. Okay, just simply we have to change the operator only, right? So now file exist and go over here and change this operator to E, right? So the statement is file exist. Here I'm just going to write $1 so that it can verify $1 file not exist. Okay, now I'm going to execute that file exist. Okay, here I'm just going to provide that file name over here. Okay, file test or something like this, or here it is there, right? File test operators, and I'm going to say that file test operator is exist. Example, say here I'm just going to provide something like there is no file called operator one, something like file test operator one. So I'm giving that file name, it says that file not exist. If I the so many things like whether the file is readable or not, okay, whether the file is block or not, something like that, maybe I can show you one more example over here is that it's a directory again copying to the block device. So we'll just verify whether the device is block device or normal device, normal file. We can use this example over here. So it can verify using the -b option. So say it's a block special device, it's not block special device. Okay, so now I'm just going to show you over here is that I have SDA over here. So we'll take that SDA block device and say SDA, which says that it's a special device. So in case of I have some TTY file, it says that it's not a block special device, so it has something different. Like that you can use a number of test cases over here to test the file characteristics using this unary operators or file test operators. So I can show you more examples over here, but just you have to change the options and provide the exactly the file where it want to locate it. But most of the example is that some cases you wanted to verify that whether the configuration file is exist or not, whether the file is executable permissions, it has executable permissions or not, whether it has a sticky bit permissions or not. Some cases you want to verify that the file characteristics, you can use these file test operators and the unary operators, which can help you to verify all these file characteristics as specified over here. File test operators, these are the operators you can use it to verify these are the characteristics you can verify using these testers. That's about it, guys. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos and courses. Thanks for watching. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.